Used to be so easy. Go to bed, snuggle down, fall asleep and dream. Now I know the difference. I feel a difference. You go to bed, lay there. Falling asleep just doesn't happen. You turn over, put on the pillow. Turn over, lay there. Turn over, check the time. The world around me seems peaceful, yet the silence is deafening and lonely. My mind is running on overtime, always thinking, endless thinking. Check the time, 2:12 a.m. I'm awake. I'm exhausted, and yet I'm still awake. I'm always awake. Time check. 2:19 a.m. This is useless.
Stars shining bright above you. Night breezes seem to whisper, I love you. Burp. We found the herbs that we need to see down. We are but our me. Night breezes seem to whisper, I love you. Birds singing in the sycamore tree. Dream a little dream of me. Say nighty night and kiss me. Just hold me tight and tell me you'll miss me. While I'm alone and blue as can be. Dream a little dream of me. But in your dreams, whatever they be, dream a little dream of me.
Hello? Silas? Silas, stop fucking around, it's not funny. What's up? What? Me? Yeah, I'm fine. I tried to get to the phone before. I stubbed my toe trying to get the phone before you woke Arthur up. Yeah, I'm fine. What did you want? Sure. Look, I'm sorry for snapping. It's late and I'm tired and you have woken me up. You dickhead. Yeah, I'll see you in a bit. Yeah, I'm fine. But see ya.
Just
sweet dreams till sunbeams find you. Sweet dreams that leave all worries behind you. But in your dreams, whatever they be, dream a little dream of me.
What are you doing?
I don't know.
Woke up on the wrong side of the bed? Okay.
Is this it? Was the rest of your stuff?
Oh, they came early and got it.
Sorry, I've got it.
No, no, okay, it's
all
right.
Silence! I've got it! Sorry, I didn't mean to snap. I'm just really tired and I've got loads on my mind at the moment.
It's fine. I like your coat, by the way.
Thanks. It was my mum's. She won't be needing it anymore. So how come you're going home so early?
I just need to sort something out with my parents. Nothing to worry about.
How are they?
Last night check, we're fine.
Is everyone okay? Are you okay?
Just drop it, yeah.
I'm fine.
What the future bring?
All the highs and lows. Said I'm gonna win, though the world might spin. Now I'm sitting here like I'm no one. It rains down on me. All the phone calls I'm ignoring. See, this house stands alone and abandoned. Where life once used to thrive. Broken walls tainted with speckles of moisture trapped beneath the surface, seeping through dark specks of mould. The stench of musk hangs in the air, which clings to my clothes and my hair. I'll have to wash these when I get home now. The wind causes the house to creak as if it's trying to speak. I wonder what it is trying to say. What would I say? Probably, I'm fine. Around me is nothing but ruin and decay. At this very moment, it feels hopeless. There seems to be too much damage, too much vulnerability. Like if I breathed the wrong way, the foundations would collapse around me, encaging me into this pitiful, tattered house. This house needs help to breathe again, to feel alive again, to become a home once again. This is not something that can be rushed. You begin to strip it back, baring the damaged areas, the cracks and dents for all to see. Patching up these exposed areas takes time and effort. You're hasty with it. You have to be, otherwise it will crumble and won't be able to support the next layer. There is no quick and easy way except putting in the dedication and the commitment. The vulnerable areas need to be seen in order to fix them before the next stage. Otherwise it won't work. The vulnerability will always be seen. This is the ugly stage. You have to prep and prepare to get messy, to feel the coldness of it splash onto your skin. Only then can you begin to change what you want others to see. You carefully begin cutting in the edges, every brushstroke making a difference. Drops of it douse onto you, which you'll find there days later despite your efforts to wash it away. More often than not, it will need more than one layer to hide what's beneath the surface, what was once there. You sit and you wait, impatient of how long it's taking. You've put in all that hard work and you can still see what's underneath. It's all changing so quick, but there's nothing you can do about it. You feel all in the pit of your stomach. It's messy, exhausting, frustrating. You feel like you'll never get there. You are among chaos, but you have to keep at it. You have to keep going. You want to make it to the end.
Hi.
I'm going to take a shower. I smell.
Mm-hmm. What are you doing?
I need some space.
No. No, what you need is a hug.
Not right now.
I want a hug.
No, I want to pack.
For what?
I'm going to go back to uni for a little bit. I need some time to myself.
Well, you can have that here.
I just want some space right now. Please, I just want to...
Stop. Look, you're just pushing me out. Let me in and try and help you.
Stop you. Suffocating me. I just want some space, please.
I'm sorry, I'm just trying to, I just want you to be happy.
Me too. I'm gonna go back to uni for a little bit.
Why don't you just stay here tonight? You look tired.
Fine.
We are alone. Nobody's watching. We might take it home. We might make out.
Bye.
I thought you weren't coming back till next week.
Change of plans.
I know it's early and it looks like you could do, like, have some of this. I know I certainly can. So. But it's fine, you know.
Come in then.
I'm fine though.
Are you okay?
No, I'm not okay. Do I look okay to you?
Do you want to talk about it?
No, it's okay. I don't want to burden you with my problems. But my boyfriend.
You can never tell what's good until you've had the bad. Until you look back and think about things and they have time to grow in your mind. Take Ellie. Here she is with a boyfriend who loves her and would never cheat on her, but she's so caught up in her own mind, her own jealousy, to realise how good she's got it. Why doesn't she just talk to him? Tell her how she feels. It's probably just a misunderstanding. Shit. Arthur. Why can't I ever take my own advice? Remember when I said you can never tell what's good until you look back? We are looking at life the wrong way. I mean, things don't need to last forever to be perfect. Am I pushing everyone away?
We won't want that now, do we?
No. We wouldn't want that.
Just sort the wardrobe, took the stuff to the charity shop like we spoke about.
Where's the coat to this hood?
One of the charity bags.
It's not, I've checked.
Well, it's probably at the charity shop then.
That was my mum's coat, I needed that.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Life is strange. Everything around me feels so fragile. My thoughts lead me to places where I get lost and unsure. Some dead echo drags me down and I no longer have confidence. I want to be finished with this. I feel just so heavy. I don't understand what's been taken from me. I have flickers of guilt for all that was left unsaid or undone. I thought I was making progress. I thought we were healing. It's not meant to happen like this. We're not meant to go backwards. Are you?
Stars shining bright above you. Night breezes seem to whisper, I love you. Yeah. Birds singing in the sycamore tree. Dream a little dream of me. Say nighty night and kiss me. Just hold me tight and tell me you'll miss me. While I'm alone and blue as can be. Dream a little dream of me. Whatever they be, dream a little dream of me.